In this video, we're going to take a look at how you can use MPE in Ableton Live. You're now able to use MPE within certain devices in Ableton Live and with any third-party plugins that support MPE. This is great for musicians and sound designers alike who want to push the boundaries of sonic expression. So what exactly is MPE? Well, MPE stands for MIDI Polyphonic Expression. It's an extension of the MIDI protocol used to control multiple parameters of a single note of any software or hardware that is MPE compatible. With MPE, each note is assigned with its own channel, so that the input messages received from an MPE controller control the parameters of each individual note. To get started with MPE, ideally you need an MPE controller. However, there are ways of utilizing MPE without the use of an MPE controller, and we'll take a look at this later in this video. With an MPE controller at hand, simply make sure to connect your controller to the appropriate port on your computer. Now go to Live's Preferences, and under the tab Link Tempo MIDI, in the MIDI port section, make sure that the MPE checkbox is activated for your MPE MIDI controller. With this now set up in your preferences, you can close the preferences window and your MPE controller is ready to use with Ableton Live. To demonstrate how MPE works in Live, I'm going to use Wavetable. I've already loaded up the device in track 1. To start mapping parameters from Wavetable to MPE, simply choose the tab labeled MPE. Here you'll find the modulation matrix where you can map parameters. MPE works along 3 different axes. An x-axis, where you can move your finger horizontally. This is usually mapped to pitch. A y-axis, where you can move your finger vertically along your MPE controller. This parameter is more commonly called slide. I'm going to use the modulation matrix and map slide to the wavetable position. As I now move my finger vertically while playing a note, I can actually move the wavetable position with this gesture. Last of all, we have the z-axis. This is more commonly known as aftertouch or pressure. I'm going to map the aftertouch to the cutoff filter of the wavetable. As I play the MPE controller and press down on the keys, I can move the filter with this gesture. So now that you've seen how you can use MPE in this particular preset, I'm now going to record a clip. Now that I've recorded my clip, I'm now going to double click on the clip so I can have a look at the detail view. The detail view now has 3 tabs. And if I select the 3rd tab, then I have access to the expression view, where I can see all of the MPE information that has been recorded to all of my notes. Let's zoom in on a couple of notes and adjust the detail view so we have clear view of all of the data that's been recorded. If I use a mouse pointer to click on any of the notes, I have immediate access to all of the breakpoints that have been recorded while I was recording the clip. By holding down the Option button on a Mac computer keyboard or the Alt button on a PC computer keyboard, when I select a breakpoint and drag it, I can simplify the number of breakpoints. I can double click with my mouse to add breakpoints. By holding down the Command button on a Mac keyboard or the Control button on a PC keyboard, when you click and drag a breakpoint, it will snap to the current grid of your clip. Since the MPE information is recorded per note, this means I can also change and manipulate the breakpoints of the slide and pressure values. You are also able to edit MPE curves just like any other automation or modulation curves in Live. Since the expression view is available to all notes that are recorded in clips of MIDI tracks, this means that you can access this section and edit MPE data without actually having to use an MPE controller. It's also worth mentioning that when you record notes with Capture using an MPE controller, all of the MPE data is also recorded with the notes that are captured. When using MPE with a third-party VST plugin, some plugins may not already be MPE enabled when you load them into a MIDI track. With a VST loaded in your MIDI track, simply right-click on the actual VST and select the Enable MPE mode from the context menu. You may also have to enable an MPE mode within the plugin itself.